Once again, this video is coming from the top of a flight case in the middle of a crew room of a show, so you'll hear sort of noises in the background and fans and stuff like that. So this is an infrared thermometer and it's faulty. It's supposed to be that when you pull the trigger, it fires an infrared beam out, it fires a red laser beam out to create a dot. And the point that you shine the dot at, it gives you an indication of the temperature in the LCD display. But this one is completely dead, and the battery's fine, but so I'm wondering if the connector's come off. So let's pop this open. And I can see there's two pillars here to start off with screws in them. But I'm not sure if they're concealed screws under the labels. I'll find out when I ease this open. I don't know if maybe these are just going to pull off. That does pull off, revealing the display and the buttons. Does the front come off? Yes, it does. Oh, there's the whole module inside. So there's a laser module. It's been sort of pressed into this sort of plastic tube, and it's been had some heat shrink put round to hold it in place. Here's the infrared detecting lens assembly, plus what I'd guess is probably going to be a little thermistor, just to measure, it's a little bead thermistor, just to measure the temperature of the actual sensor area itself to get an ambient temperature, and that will offset to the temperature of the device it's looking at. So let's pop this out. Oops, springs that we want, springy things. So release. Let's put the battery on and measure and see if power's getting onto the board in the first place. I'll measure that from the back here. So let's bring the meter in. I'll use my travelling meter. Oh, it's picking a lovely picture of the magic arm that I'm using to hold this camera in position. So let's put that onto these connections. So power is getting onto the PCB. So if there's nothing really obvious in terms of broken connections or anything like that, I would say that there may actually be a problem with the chip under here may have died, and that's a bit of a sort of terminal situation because it's one of those cobbed chip on board type things like that. And I'm guessing that really there's not much you can do when these chips fail here, because they're just not replaceable, and even if it was replaceable, it would maybe cost more to get replacement chips in some instances than it would to just replace the whole unit. But let's treat this as a dead unit and take it to bits. The laser module looks very common. It's a little brass module. Let's take this little bead thermistor off with its sticky pad that holds it on and take a look at the sensor, which should be quite interesting. Oh, so it's got about four pins, two which may be screened. I wonder if they're mainly for support. That feels quite heavy, this assembly. It feels like it may actually be metal or very dense plastic. And it's looking into one of those sort of polythene lenses to actually shape the beam a bit there to give it the sort of area it's going to cover. There are just two connections going into the back of this, though. So I'm guessing it's just going to be a pyroelectric device which is putting out a small voltage differential. I'm not sure if that'll have some sort of amplifier in it. I guess it could, like a lot of these devices, like the passive infrared detector units, use the little high-gain transistor inside to initially boost the signal up. I'm guessing that might be the same here. So it's putting out basically a sort of acting as an analog sort of voltage. So the chip can actually just basically determine the temperature from ultimate. I'm guessing if it's the transistor, it'll be a sort of resistance it sees. But there's not a lot in them. They're mass produced. That's what you'd expect. What looks like a little voltage regulator down here. Not sure where that chip will be. And then just the usual blob and the LCD in the back, which will be doing most of the stuff. So it's interesting how it's put together. It is very mass produced, and kind of simple-ish inside, but that's just what happens with mass-produced products.